you know, Mr. Cohen, he goes up there to Congress to have a little chatty do with some of our senators because they needed a hearing. And if you don't mind, I'm going to try to break it down for you. Let's do this as succinctly as possible. Then we'll get into some of the deeper nuggets of information. Here, we had a bunch of proven liars holding a hearing, and their star witness was going to jail because he was lying to Congress. First time in the history of Congress, I do believe. Because those Democrats want witnesses of integrity. Now, this person was telling tales about a president who uses hyperbole to express himself. Now, some would consider that lying. Others would consider that what it is, exaggeration. Now, this was given full coverage, ladies and gentlemen, by the mainstream mountebank media. Full coverage. So who are we supposed to believe in this matter? If you ask me, my little analysis of the situation, I would say it's a wash. From my perspective, nothing new was learned, and it was told by a proven liar. So, as succinctly as possible, this is what happened. Liars told lies about liars who lied on liars. Now say that 10 times in a row, record that, and send that to me. And I'll give you some kind of prize. Now, if anything, this whole experience was a waste of taxpayer dollars and airtime. Why would they even give this person, a proven liar, any validity by giving him wall-to-wall coverage in the mainstream mountebank media? And you know it's only getting heated up at this point. It's only going to go on right up until the election. I can see so many things right now a mile away. I may do a few predictions. This is all being done to continue to taint Trump as if he needs it. This is the problem I have with the whole thing. Why do you have to make up lies about Trump? He's got enough flaws that you could attack without having to make up stuff about him. That's why you can't believe anybody. The whole Cohen thing. Liars bring up a liar to tell lies about a liar who tells lies on liars. It's all frustrating. And all of this was paid for by the United States taxpayers and sponsored by the mainstream mountebank media. Notice how I've changed that. That's our new term for them. Now, where was the scrutiny from the Democrats and the media when Obama was in office and all the scandals that were wrapped around him? Where was the scrutiny on Hillary Clinton? Mountebank. A person who sells quack medicine from a platform. Like the media, you know, I would say the media fills that description. Then we had Conceso Cortez, who for some reason is getting all kinds of spotlight. A nobody from nowhere, apparently, is getting all kinds of spotlight. Now, she was even at these hearings, a nobody, a freshman. You would think that people who have been in the Senate longer on the Democrat side, who may have earned a position on this panel to question a liar. No, they allow her, Ocasio Cortez, to get some spotlight. And her questions were basically follow-ups from other Democrats that were making questions of Mr. Conan. I don't know why everybody's obsessed with Trump's taxes. See, to me, again, you're talking a banger here. What a person pays in taxes is too much, no matter who you are. A government that has to take money from everybody in egregious amounts to run itself and still can't keep the budget in order, blows past the debt ceiling, as we'll talk about later on in the headlines. Excuse me for that. I think I need a little drink here, so I'm going to take a quick sip, if you don't mind. So, Ocasio Cortez asked a couple questions of Mr. Conan that got the left all happy. And they might have been good follow-up questions. She asked, did the president ever provide inflated assets to an insurance company? Cohen said yes. Okay, so Trump lied about, from a liar. A liar is telling Ocasio Cortez and the Democrats and the nation that Trump lied to an insurance company, another wonderful, great industry. You know, if you think about it, the three industries that are just really holding on to America with a fist is the banking industry, it's the insurance industry, and it's the medical industry. But that's a whole other subject. Maybe we need to know if Trump lied. I would think if the insurance company was concerned about that, it would be on them to proceed with legal matters, not Congress. But that's just me. If that really was the case, bringing it up in front of the nation, told to you by a liar, I'm supposed to believe that. I'm supposed to believe that as an American. Then she asked, who else knows the president did this? And we got three gentlemen, which will probably be subpoenaed at some point, either by Congress or by some kind of other FBI investigation, maybe a Russian probe, who knows? Yeah, it's interesting how a Russian probe has gone away from Russian involvement, and now it's completely on Trump's personal business dealings, his banking situation, how much money he has, and so on and so forth. No longer is the Russian investigation about Russian collusion. I guess they couldn't find that. They found these other things. Like the Cohen, he's going to jail for lying and paying off hookers. Like that's a big deal. Like that is a big deal when you break it down. That had nothing to do with Russian collusion. Yet, oh my goodness, the entire media obsessed with this. Obsessed with his taxes. Obsessed with everything except what he is doing as president. Outside of, you know, it's bad, it's awful that he wants to put up a wall. That's their biggest concern they have as Trump being president, is putting up a wall as some sort of racist, bigoted act by a guy with orange hair. Just great. So Ocasio Cortez, who I have to say, they're giving her the spotlight for some reason, ladies and gentlemen. I'm telling you right now, you better listen closely because you're going to look back on this in 5 or 6 years and say, wow, the banger's right on the money. And if I'm wrong, well, oh well, it's better for America than I am wrong on this. But let me tell you about Miss Ocasio Cortez. She is being groomed to be a presidential candidate, and you can mark my words on that. Just like Obama, she is coming out of nowhere. Yep, Barry. Remember? Do you remember Barry spending so many years in Congress to become, and then he becomes, no, He was there for a little bit, one, maybe two terms. I don't know precisely. But it was only to give him a stepping stone so they could make him president. Now, here's my prediction, ladies and gentlemen, and you can take this to the bank. Trump will be allowed to win in 2020. Why will he be allowed to win? Because it's going to allow the left-wing Democrats, they may take the Senate then. They're probably going to take the Senate, but it's going to allow the Democrats to just harp on this guy, demonize this guy. You know what he is. He's a bigot, homophobe, sexist, misogynist. You know all those terms. They're going to allow this guy to win because look at the presidential candidates on the left right now. Garbage. All of them garbage. Trump will be able to wipe the floor with all of them. But they're setting this up for Conceso Cortez to come in. She will run and win in 2024. That's just 5 years out. Mark it down. March 3rd, 2019. The banger says, Conceso Cortez will run for office president and she will win in 2024. Let me give you a little background on her before we get out of here. Her term will be up as senator. Here's some good stuff. This is how I know she will be anointed. She'll be lifted up. She was born Friday, February 13th, 1989. Now you know, if you've been a longtime listener, how I study numbers. And I see patterns with these. Well, I can tell you Friday the 13th is a clue. Friday the 13th is a clue. 1989. Now, if you take the 8 and then 1 together and you put it in 9, you have 3 9s. You flip them over, what do you have? Now, let's move on, folks. She's a nobody, and there's nothing special about her, except she's a feminist, socialist, progressive that can be the face of the one world agenda in the future. Look at all the attention she's getting. How did she become so prominent and get a prominent seat at a public hearing? She's a freshman senator. She's being set up to be the 2024 presidential candidate. They're going to let Trump win, and she's going to come in when Trump's done, and the Republicans have nobody. She's going to come in, and she's going to be the perfect Democrat Party presidential candidate. And by then, there will be so many people with the same background as her voting. It'll be an easy slam dunk win, very much like Obama.